Hello and welcome to our third class on mathematical typing. In our last class, we learned how to write various symbols using the shortcuts. Now in this class, we'll use those shortcuts and we'll get all of these equations without using the insert tab, and also we'll try to reduce and minimize the usage of mouse. So we'll only try and focus to use the keyboard itself and minimize the use of insert tab, also our mouse. So moving on to the very first equation, to get my equation tab over here, what we use is alt equal to, and we get the equation tab. Within the equation tab, let me just change this. Okay, we have L equal to, then we have square root V by H. To get the square root, we use the backward slash over here. Backward slash, and then we'll write sqrt space, and you get the square root. Just click on the space once more to move out of it. Then again you get this square box over here. Then click on the left arrow. The moment you click on the left arrow, you move inside the box. Now over here, what you can do is you can just write v by h. Now it's the simplest way to do that is just write v forward slash h and space. The moment you hit space, you get v by h. So this was the easiest way of getting v by h, right? Moving on to the next one, alt equal to. Now the next one is a little trickier. We'll start by writing h equal to. Then after this, you do not have to move always from outward to inwards always when you are using shortcuts, because when you are using shortcuts, you have this thing that you can move from left to right. Then you do not have to always follow moving from outward to inwards what we did in our first class. So over here, moving from left to right, what we'll do is we'll insert the first bracket. We can write 3v, give the forward slash, then 2, and for the pi symbol, we know we use the backward slash, pi, space, and you get the pi. Close the bracket. For the time being, just ignore the size of the bracket, because once the moment you leave the equation tab, the size will readjust itself. So now to get 1 by 3, we use the caret symbol over here. Open the bracket, 1, again by 3, close the bracket, hit space, and the moment you click on the space, it all of it adjusts itself. Right? Moving on to the third one, again I'll get the equation tab, alt equal to. This we can again write using mu, backward slash mu, and we get mu over here. Then we have summation I x by n. So now the second method of using fractions. So over here we saw we can write 3v forward slash 2pi. Over here what you can do is, first you can give the forward slash, click on the space, and then you get both numerator and denominator, which you can change and manipulate. So this is the second method of using fractions. I can click on the left arrow. Moment you click on the left arrow, you move to the denominator. Over here you just write n. Click on the up arrow to move to the numerator. Over here give the backward slash, sum, space, and you get the summation symbol. To get I in the subscript, use underscore I, hit space, and you get in the underscore as I. Then just write x over here. So this is your third equation. These are my very first three equations. Moving on to my next three equations which I have over here. So let me just get the equation tab, alt equal to. The very first one starts with a limit. So over here what we'll do is, let me just move on to the home tab, and what I can do is I can just write lim. I'll start by writing lim itself. Then I want x tends to 5. So for this, write underscore x, hit space, and the moment you hit space, you get this entire thing, limit x, and then this square box which you have. To get x tends to 5, what do you do is that you click on the left arrow twice. So I clicked on the left arrow twice. The moment you click on the left arrow twice, you get it as x. Then you can write the left arrow. So the two methods of getting the right arrow, the two methods of getting the right arrow is, one, to use the backward slash and write the entire thing, right arrow, click space, and you get the right arrow. The easiest way which we have seen is again to use minus and greater than sign, and you get the right arrow, minus, greater than sign, and then you can just write 5. Again, to move back to this particular portion, just click on the right arrow twice. So you click on the right arrow twice, again you get back to this box over here. To write x square minus 25 and all of this, the second method of using fractions is what I would suggest. You can just click on the forward slash, hit space, and then again left arrow. So left arrow will take you to the denominator. Over here you can just write x, and again if you want to just remove these, so you can do that using shortcut keys Control B and Control I to remove the bold and italics. It's up to you. Then x, again to square it, use the caret over here, 2 space, you get x square plus x and minus 30. For the numerator, click on the up arrow to move to the numerator, x caret 2 minus 25. So this was your, again I can change this to, change the entire thing to simply, yeah. This was my fourth equation. Moving on to the fifth one. It seems a little big, but then it's very simple again. Alt equal to, you get the equation tab. Let me start from the very left. So I will always prefer and start from the very left. I'll write S bracket K bracket close equal to, moving on. I need this integral sign. Now to get the integral sign, what we'll do over here is, what we can do, we can write, as we know, to get integral sign we write int. So int space, and you get the integral sign. Now the moment you get the integral sign, you need something as 1 and k in the as the lower bound you need 1, as the upper bound you need k. Now how to get this? So see this very carefully. Use the underscore button, underscore, which means is for the subscript. Subscript we have 1. So 1. For the upper bound, which is k, use the caret and k. Hit space. The moment you hit space, it automatically adjusts itself as 1 and k over here. So this is the beauty of writing it using the shortcut keys, right? Moving on, you have 2 pi. So 2 pi, this is very simple. We have 1 by x. Again, we can write it, just give 1 space. 1 by x, and you get 1 by x as well. Then we have square root, so I can just use square root and you get the square root. Click on the space again, so you move outside of the square root. Click on the left arrow to move inside. Over here we then use 1 plus. Now this is a little trickier. We'll use the third bracket. So the third bracket, then we have d by dx. So again we can write d forward slash dx, hit space, and you get d by dx. Don't worry about the size of the bracket because it will get adjusted. Then we open the first bracket, 1 by x, close the bracket, and it adjusts, automatically it adjusts itself. Again close the bracket. Then for square portion, we'll use the caret, hit space, and see, you get your square. So this was very simple case. Now just click on the right arrow twice, as what I did. My equation was like this. Now if you start writing dx, this will be within your square root, which is not what I want. So click on right arrow twice, right arrow once, right arrow twice, and then you move outside of the square root. Just write dx and your fifth equation is done. So it's very simple. You just need to practice it maybe once and you are done with the code, done with the equation, right? Moving on to the very last one, which we have over here, alt equal to. Now we have this equation for standard deviation. To get sigma, we just write, let me just do one thing. Okay, alt equal to, and then we have sigma over here. Sigma, hit space and you get the sigma symbol, equal to, again we need a square root, hit space and you get the square root. After the square root, what you can do is two things. I'll prefer the second one, forward slash, I need to first move inside. So left arrow, forward slash, space, left arrow key to move to the numerator, which is n, and in the numerator, sorry, denominator is n, and in the numerator we have, brackets x minus x bar. Now how to get x bar? This is very simple. X, give a backward slash, bar, hit space and you get x bar. Hit space again and it adjusts itself. Close the bracket and caret 2, space, and you get your entire equation. So these were my 6 quick equations with usage of shortcuts. Now I just need to show you all one thing, one very quick thing over here. Suppose in this equation itself, what happens? Suppose you are within the equation. So alt equal to, you are within the equation, and suppose I want to write x equal to 4, comma, this is within the equation, right? Y equal to 5, then solve x square plus y square. If this is what I want to write, but then this then solve should not be within the equation. It should be outside of the equation, just a normal text. This over here and this over here should be within the equation. Now how to solve this problem? You just need to select this entire portion. Click on alt equal to again. And then what happens? This entire thing moves outside of the equation. So you have equation over here, you have equation over here, but then this thing is not within the equation. So you can use this, I'll just add a comma. So you use this, you can just select your text, click on alt equal to again to make whatever you want outside of the equation. If it is within the equation, you can just get it outside of the equation. So this was very simple. I just selected this entire thing and click on alt equal to get this outside of the equation. So these were the quick ways. Again, I'll show you all one more quick thing over here. If you want to use an inbuilt equation, suppose, so I'll just select any one of the equation over here which we have. So let me just select this, and suppose you want to make any changes, the changes can be done very easily. You can just access it using, maybe I want a beta over here. So you get in beta. Over here also I want a beta instead of this. So I'll write beta. So similarly, you can just make changes if you want to make changes to your existing equation. To add any specific equation to your, let me just hit space over here. Okay, so if you want to move anything within the equation, within your built-in equations, you can just need to click on the arrow over here, save as new equation, and then you can just give any name you want to. Click on OK. The moment you click on OK, it will save to your built-in equations, and then you can use it again and again if you want to. So this was it in my third class. In the fourth class, we'll start with the annuities CM1, CS1, CM2 and CS2 separately, and we'll see how we can solve some of the sums in Word. Thank you.